One use case is to use BigQuery for pre-processing the training data. So the TensorFlow or the machine learning engine or ML engine itself is not suited for the duty or the pre-processing or collecting all the data from enterprise systems. So you can use BigQuery as a data lake, so you can gather all the data coming from the enterprise, like application server, web server, databases, all imported to the BigQuery and do some pre-processing on that. Then you can output export the data as a training data to the TensorFlow or ML engine. So let's take a look at the actual demonstration for that. Here, I'd like to use the Cloud Datalab to use the BigQuery for preparation or pre-processing, and use the TensorFlow to train the neural network model for machine learning analytics. So this is the sample code I have prepared that is called Classifying Manhattan. Here we are importing a bunch of the location data from BigQuery and train the neural network model to classify whether each location is Manhattan or not. So let me clear all the cells first. Now let's take a look at what kind of the training data set we'll be using by executing this query. So I'll be using another public data set called NYPD collisions that records all the car accidents happened in the New York City with its timestamp and borrow, latitude, and longitude. But you cannot use this raw data as it is. You have to do pre-processing to that because you can see that some rows doesn't have any borrow data, some rows doesn't have any latitude and longitude. Now we have to remove those useless garbage data. So again, you can use the BigQuery to do this kind of the pre-processing. And also, I want to have a new program, is Manhattan, to have a flag that represents whether the latitude and longitude is inside Manhattan or not. So this is the SQL I'll be using for pre-processing, and let me execute it. And also, you can also execute another code to extract all the data from BigQuery, import it into the Python. So now you have all the data imported into Python code. So as you can see, by using Cloud Datalab, you can seamlessly integrate the BigQuery query with the Python code you write. And you can continue to use your scikit-learn or the NumPy code running on BigQuery. Sorry about my voice. So now we have the training data set. One is the is Manhattan. This could be used as a label for training, whether each location is in Manhattan or not, and pairs of the latitude and longitude for 10,000 rows. So let's do the feature scaling. Before starting training, usually in machine learning, you have to clean the data out, cleansing of the data. And one important thing is the feature scaling. And if you do the scaling and plotting the data, you can see the training data set would look like this. Now, everything is centered on the zero, but still you can see the shape of the Manhattan here, and you can even see there's a Central Park inside the data set. So this will be the training data set for neural network. We'll be splitting the data into training data and test data, and use TensorFlow to define your neural network. Here I'm using TensorFlow, especially the so-called high-level API of TensorFlow. And this is one of the features we have recently announced with TensorFlow 1.0, where you can just run a few lines of Python code to define neural networks. Before that, we have been using so-called low-level API, where you have to define all the computation graph, a low-level computation graph to define your own neural network. But now you can just write a few lines of code with Python. So you can see we are defining deep neural networks with the 4 hidden layers, and each hidden layer has 20 nodes. So we have the high neural networks. Let's check the current accuracy of the neural networks and how these neural networks can classify the Manhattan without before doing the actual training. So now you'll be seeing the map crushed by the neural networks. So this is the how neural network thinks where the Manhattan is before training. So because this is before training, the neural networks is stupid enough. It's too stupid, to crush by Manhattan. He thinks this is the new Manhattan. So this is where we have to train the neural network model. The accuracy is 75%. So you can write a for loop to repeatedly call the fit method to train the model by using the training data set. So now it will be showing the, gradually showing the better accuracy. So you are seeing that neural network model is trying to adjust how to classify each data points to get better result. So that network is getting much smarter and smarter, as you have saw on the playground demonstration. Yes, it's getting much, much better. So now training is finished. We got the 99.8% accuracy. And now neural network is trained to the, split the Manhattan and Brooklyn with the very sophisticated curve between them.